To make the pinhole glasses, we're going to find an old frame. Now you can use any old frame. I'm using one that had prescription glasses in it because you can open and close it. And so you can just, I pulled the lenses out here. Okay, and you can buy these for a dollar in a thrift store. These are old prescription reading glasses that someone had. And I pulled them out. And I'll keep this lens because then I make an outline of the lens. And see, I've done two outlines there. I'll just use a pin because you're going to use some plastic, black plastic. It's strong enough. You could have it a little bit, you want it a little bit flexible. You don't want it too, you don't want it too thin because then it's going to, won't sit nicely. This will be rigid enough to sit nicely in the lens. I figured that I'd use a pin, and for me a safety pin is good because it's a good thickness and you can hold it over here and put it in the heat, the candle. This is what we do to burn a hole through there. Is it hot enough? Once it's hot enough it'll just go through, it'll melt through there. Oh well, okay, have it in the flame. Okay, that should be hot enough. See? And that's how we do all our holes. Now, to get the size of the holes, we've got the pin, this pin head, which I think is a good safety pin head, which is a good size. But to actually get the measurements, you can either, if you've already got a pair of pinholes, you can just get the measurements of that. You can have a stencil, which, well, I got this off the internet. I just found pinhole glasses and looked in the images, and I found a black and white, which is, this is white and black, but it was the black background with the white holes, and you were supposed to just print it out and use it, but that uses too much ink, so I just inverted it in my Photoshop and it changed the white holes into black on white. That way I just did a fast print and I didn't use much ink because I was going to use it as a stencil, and that'll give you the right spacing. But when you're printing it out, make sure that you're printing it out so that they're an eighth of an inch apart. Each dot is an eighth of an inch apart. And that way you'll get the right spacing. Now if you can't find a stencil that was suitable, use graph paper. Or it might be called engineering paper or technical drawing paper, drafting paper. It's the paper that's got the squares printed on it. Little squares and then darker lines as they get to make bigger squares. So, and you'll be able to use that to position your holes. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take this off as soon as I get all those holes nicely. And then see, there's a few there that need to be redone. So once they're nice and clear, I'm going to put the lens back in here. So here we've got the black lens that we've cut out. We've got our stencil here. And we're going to attach the stencil to the lens. Now we're going to use a little bit of masking tape. That way it won't, once we've got the masking tape fixed, it won't move. And we don't want this stencil to move because we want all the holes to line up. Okay, now I'm just heating it up here. if it goes through, if it's hard to get it through, it means it's not hot enough. If it goes through like butter, it's doing well. And you can do, watch, I'll do a couple with this. This is nice and hot. One, two, I might even get three out of that. See, oh yeah, did four. Five, it's not going to, see, it's already hard, so. And you just go through them. Now, some of them are going to be thinner and some of them are going to be thicker marginally. It just depends how far down you put your hole and how hot the plastic, the needle was. If the needle's very hot, it's going to make a bit larger hole. So it's probably best just to do two or three. Otherwise you end up with a small hole you have to go through again. So I've ripped off the paper, but as you can see, the paper is stuck to the plastic and there's lots of bits of plastic still there. So I'm just going to sandpaper that and see how that goes. What we're using now is a knife to scrape that off. I tried a sandpaper, but the sandpaper doesn't work well. I'm scraping it here. You'll see there's all those little high bits, they're coming off there just easily with a knife there. Okay, so there they're finished. I had to sand them a bit, so I just got some black texture marking pen and just went over it to give it a nice black finish.